old-time tobacco. Yes, peanuts, cotton, hogs, and everything else having to do with the land. But above all, in Virginia, it was King Tobacco, the jovial weed to which all of Europe was addicted at the time.
Thank you. That scene that you paint of humans being girded like animals into a pen is horrendous. Yeah.
But Patine, none of that is to be found in the history books that were sort of meted out to us, you know, in the North. And I'm sure that my editor never came across that in any history book.
Yeah, you see.
One had to be very purposeful in seeking out the history oneself.
A book recently, A. Lincoln, by Ronald White, is a whole other side of the man Abraham Lincoln that we think of, you know, 67 years. Mm-hmm. It's, again, what this man really, you know, was exposed to slavery, didn't think it was so awful to begin with.
Yes,
and yet this is the man we...
Absolutely. Yeah. Freely use the word nigger and so on.
Yeah. Horrendous. Yeah.
And yet we praise him. There he is, you know, each time we go to Washington, overseeing it all.
Right. You go to the Barbados to look up your genealogy, so to speak, and come across the aunt, the woman who sent everybody off.
Only one of the 14 children that refused to be sent was not interested in going north. She didn't care about brownstone houses. She wanted nothing to do with them. She loved that little dot of an island, just the smallest of the islands. And she loved being a market woman. This was her trade, her profession. She loved it.
She knew who she was.
She did indeed. Yes.
Paul, the other is, of course, by this point of right after you are awarded, I mean, incredible, MacArthur Genius Award, really, and the Guggenheim, which allows you to go back to Granada and have three and help a house. Your child has a nanny.
Yes, I love that chapter because for the first time, I lived well in the islands.
Yeah.
You know, because I would get these little grants. And as my first editor was very adamant about the whole issue of my staying around New York, he said, get out of New York. You have a little bit of money. We can't give you much advance, but you'll be able to stretch it far better if you get out of New York and go to these islands. Mm-hmm. You see, and this is what I did for the longest time. And so then, when, after giving up hope of anything like a MacArthur, there comes a telephone call. I was writing, I remember, I was working on a book, The Fisher King. Mm-hmm. I think my last novel. And having a terrible time with that novel.
It just wouldn't
come to me. The telephone rang. And I was so upset, I snatched up the phone, you know. And it was this wonderful voice from Chicago calling me from the MacArthur Foundation.
And she said, I think you'd better sit down, Miss Marshall.
You know, and even when she sort of spelled out the details, I couldn't believe it. Couldn't, she said, once, just sit there for a while, for 15 minutes or so, and then call me back so that we can go over this again.
Yeah.
It will have greater reality then.
Yeah, how wise of her.
Yes, indeed.
You talk about, though, as you go off there and everything's going, your writer's block. What do you advise your students when they have that?
I tell them the story of my writer's block, and I tell them I hope yours is not as bad. But there's no really avoiding it in one way or another. Sometimes it just doesn't come in the way that you anticipate it will. And you have to just, in a sense, stay with it until it begins to give. Or if it's too recalcitrant, maybe it's telling you that this is not the book for you to write.
Yeah.
Maybe not now, maybe down the line or so.
Well, you said that about that period in your life. It did give you food for thought later on.
Yes.
How do you teach writing?
I try to give them great respect and deference to the art.
To
insist that they can't settle for the word that they think might work. Mm-hmm. They've got to work to find the right one. Yeah. And that sometimes takes a long time. That it demands a willingness to, in a sense, give over the self
yeah.
to the craft.
Yeah.
And if you're not willing to do that, if you think somehow it will come to you,
yeah.
no, you go to it.
Yeah.
You create
the
it.
The other is, do you advise them, rewrite, rewrite, rewrite?